These are my tools to create awesome PS4 tutorials. Let's do this.
Hey guys, this is Versatile from Project Phoenix Media. We've got a really great PS4 tutorial today. And what we're going to do is we're going to use this microcontroller chip. This is the ESP8266 with Wi-Fi. And what we're going to do is we're going to program this guy to run a custom firmware so we can host the web exploit to jailbreak your PS4 that's running firmware 4.55. So how that works is later in this video tutorial, I'll show you all the files that you require to flash it over. Once that is done, basically all you gotta do is connect this chip to your PS4 using a micro USB cable through one of the USB ports on your PS4. And then what's gonna happen is it's gonna host its own Wi-Fi network. You have the PS4 connect to that network, and then you're able to run the web exploit, and you're never exposed to the internet, so you don't have to worry about your console being banned accidentally by Sony. It's a great offline solution. It's simple to use, and I'll show you how this is all gonna work. So with that said, let's jump straight into the next portion of this video tutorial. Let's do this.
Okay, so once you're back on your computer, what you're gonna need to do, most likely, is get the proper drivers for your ESP8266. So in my case, I'm using Windows 10, and it turns out I needed to get the Windows 10 drivers in order for my chip to be recognized properly. So I have a link in the video description. Go to this website here and go ahead and download the Windows 10 Universal driver setup. If you have an older operating system like Windows 7 or 8 or 8.1, you can download, I believe, this guy. Or if you're XP, you can download this guy. Download it and install it, and you'll be good to go from a driver standpoint. Next, we need this additional program called NodeMCU Pi Flasher 3.0. You can get it for x64 or x86. Since I have a Windows 10 64-bit machine, I went ahead and downloaded this particular file. So go ahead and download the correct file for your operating system. And this will allow us to flash the ESP8266 properly with the custom firmware. And with that said, where do we get the custom firmware? So this is one developer, RetroGamer74. He's got a lot of great files here. He has one particular version, which is the V3 version, which is pretty cool. And he has this other one, which is a V2, but it does the job as well. So for today's example, we're actually going to use this particular firmware file. So if we click on this link here, you can say clone or download the whole thing, or just go ahead and click on this particular .bin file. So I already downloaded the entire archive as a zip file, so we're just going to use that in today's example. And in the video description, I have a link to another developer if you want to play around and use another web exploit that looks a little bit different, but still gets the job done, basically. And then over here on my desktop, I happen to have this test app.pkg. So I'll showcase that later in today's video tutorial on how to use it. But basically what you do is you have a FAT32 thumb drive or hard drive, copy that over to the root, and then when you plug that into your PS4, after you have run the exploit, you can go ahead and install package files. It's pretty cool. So what we're gonna do first is let's extract this Windows driver. And then I'm gonna go into that folder. Since I'm running x64, let's go ahead and run that installer. Click on next, and we're good to go. Great. And then I'm gonna go ahead and extract this firmware file before I forget. Okay, we're good to go. And then now let's go ahead and plug in your ESP8266 into your computer. So I have a USB cable to micro USB, you know, like your cell phone cable, basically. So plug it in. Now, after you plug in your chip, let's go ahead and run the NodeMCU program. Okay, great. So serial port, click on this. It's gonna differ from every single computer, but for my computer, it happens to be COM3. NodeMCU firmware, click on browse, and I'm gonna go to my desktop here, and I'm gonna go to the firmware file, and I'm gonna select the RetroGamerFirm_EN for English, press open. For the baud rate, you can go with the default, but I've experimented with the highest, fastest rate, and I had no issues, so I'm gonna use that for today's video tutorial. Of course, if yours has issues, by all means, go ahead and select the slower speed until it successfully flashes over. So 92/1600, I'm gonna use that. Flash mode, I'm gonna leave it default as dual IO. And erase flash, I'm gonna say yes, wipe all data, and click on this button, flash NodeMCU. So in the video description, I have a link to all these different websites that I just talked about previously, and also an Amazon link to the exact chip that I used if you wanna follow along, and if you wanna get this particular chip, if you wish, from Amazon. I recommend do not use baud rate 9600. When I first tried to do this on my own, it took about 20 or 30 minutes, something ridiculous like that. So don't do that. You'll thank me later if you select the fastest speed. Okay, leaving. Done. So literally it's done. And then that's pretty much. So you can go ahead. You can go ahead, unplug it from your computer. You can now plug it into the USB port, one of the USB ports on the front of the PS4. So what happens next is when you turn on your PS4, you're going to search under the network connections, and find your PS4 Wi-Fi network, I believe is what it's called. Once you're connected to it, you go into user's guide, you'll see the exploit, and you have a lot of good time. So in the next portion of the video tutorial, I'm going to go walk through all of that, and it's going to be awesome. So let's do this. Okay, so here we are at the PS4, so let's do this. Press the PS button, log into the local account, and then what we're going to do is basically go into settings and set up these network settings. So I'll go to network. We can see that I have the connect to internet enabled. Set up internet connection, Wi-Fi, use Wi-Fi, go to custom, and then that Wi-Fi network that we're going to use is going to be called PS4 Wi-Fi. So that's the ESP8266. Select that. And then we're just going to continue with the wizard. So automatic for IP address, do not specify, manual. Here you set your primary and your secondary DNS as 10.10.10.1. I've done that before. So let's go ahead, go to next. Automatic for MTU, do not use for proxy, and test internet connection. So this is good. We'll get the IP address, and then internet connection will say like unsuccessful or failed, which is perfectly fine. All right, so let's go check some other stuff here real quick. So if we go down to system, and we see that system information, I'm 4.55, there's my IP address, all is good. Automatic downloads, everything is unchecked just to be on the safe side. And now let's have some real fun. So let's go to settings, go all the way to the top to user's guide, and then it's gonna run the exploit. Awesome, so here's all a lot of different payloads, so to speak, that's enabled or installed on this web exploit. So you got enable blocker that blocks the PS4 from doing updates. You have like an enable browser that enables a web browser, for example, and a lot of other things here. But what we're mainly interested in is in Hen. So let's run that guy. And now it will say that, you know, Hen is enabled or something to that effect. So exploit is enabled, great. Now you can install package files and you can run them. So you scroll all the way down now to debug settings. Go to game, package installer, and now we have the package file on my FAT32 formatted thumb drive. So run that guy, we can install it. Once that is done, it's gonna be on the main home screen, X and B screen, and we can run that program. So let's see what that looks like. So go back, main menu, test application, awesome, let's run it. And there you go, everything is working. So you had homebrew games, homebrew content in the future, it'll be the exact same process, basically. So now what happens if you don't do the web exploit, you try to run this program, what's going to happen? Well, basically, it won't run. So let me just showcase that real quick. I'm going to restart the PS4 and show you what that looks like if you don't follow through with the web exploit and try to run the programs offline the wrong way. So we're back, we're gonna go ahead and log into my local account here. And let's go ahead and you see that there's a lock on there. So let's run the test application and we see that, nah, it's not gonna work, can't use the content, sorry. Well, we're gonna make it work. So let's go to settings, go back to user guide, run the web exploit, awesome. Once that's done, let's run the Hen again. Xvortex 1.4. And it's gonna say exploit enabled, awesome. Let's go back to the main menu. So let's go back. Finally, we're back. Run the test application. Yeah, it has a lock, but look, it's working. That's awesome. So that's today's video tutorial in a nutshell using the ESP8266, hosting the web exploit for the PS4. If you guys have any nitpicky questions, leave a comment here on the YouTube page. I'll get back to you as soon as possible. Once again, thank you for watching. Take care. Bye.